In this video, we will explore performing various analyses on identical data using multiple layers in OriginPro. Let's open the project. Here we have two column data. Now what we will do is, I have selected Gaussian type data in aim to conduct various fittings. We can choose from various analyses. I have opted to fit different functions to this data for a comparative analysis. I will apply four different functions to this data set. For that, let me select the data and navigate to the four panel plot, and I will be conducting four separate analyses. We can see it has a four panel layout with four layers plotted. Upon inspection, we observe layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, and layer 4. Now I have the data here which is being plotted. Next, I select layer 2. Here I want to plot this data, so I will select this column. As I hover my cursor over it and the multilayer plot icon appears, I will need to click and drag it here. A notification appears indicating that a portion of it lies outside the current axis limit. Would you like to rescale it? Yes, I opt to rescale it. Clicking OK, the same data now appears here, essentially replicating the original. Similarly, as I did before, I drag it here, once again it prompts and I confirm by selecting yes. Thus, the data is replicated here. As the multilayer plot appears, I drag the data here, completing the fourth layer. Now I proceed with a Gaussian function and aim to perform the fitting using it. Since there are various Gaussian functions available, I will utilize different ones for this purpose. Let's begin by selecting this data. Then navigating to the Analysis tab, I proceed to Fitting. Under Fitting, I opt for the Nonlinear Curve Fit and open the dialog. Upon opening the dialog, I can choose from various functions. Let's explore under the origin functions. I move toward peak functions. Within peak functions, I find Gauss, Gaussian, Gauss amp for amplitude, and Gauss mod functions. So we will proceed with each of these functions here. As we have four panels, each will be associated with one function. We will conduct the fitting and examine the differences among these functions. Clicking on Gauss, I observe its formula, which consists of Y0, W, pi by 2, and others. Additionally, there is a sample curve representing it. I am particularly interested in the formula. Here is the formula for the Gauss function, and here is the formula for the Gaussian function, which differs significantly. Likewise, the Gaussian aim function is straightforward. It is simply y equal y naught, a very basic equation. However, the Gauss mod function is substantially different. Its equation differs, and if we look at the sample curve, it appears like this. I will experiment with these using different functions. Let's begin. Since I have selected this data, I will begin with the Gauss function. Here is the fitting with the Gauss function. let me proceed and initiate the fitting process. Therefore, I will experiment with these various functions. Let's begin with this one. Since I have selected this data, I will commence with this function first. I proceed to fit, and as the fitting improves, I continue in this manner. Eventually, it reaches the best fit. Clicking OK, it is fitted here, displaying the data which I will inspect shortly. So we will conduct each of these here. We have four panels available, therefore we will use these four functions for the four panels. We will conduct the fitting and compare the differences between them. Next, I select this one and return to Analysis, then Fitting. Here I navigate to the Nonlinear Curve Fit and open the dialog. Under Peak Functions, I choose the next function, Gaussian. And proceed with the fitting. I perform a few quick iterations and continue fitting until convergence. Once fitted, I click OK and the data will be displayed here. Yes, here it is, and I will examine it shortly. Now I will select this one and proceed to Analysis, then Fitting, Nonlinear Curve Fit, and open the dialog. Under Peak Functions, I now opt for the new function, the Gauss Aim function. Here it is. So it has just been fitted. I perform some iterations and continue fitting until it converges. After fitting, I click OK and its data will appear here. Finally, I proceed with the last function. I go to Fitting, then to Nonlinear Curve Fit and open the dialog. Here, under Peak Functions, I select the last one, which is the Gauss Mod function. It has completed the fitting. I perform some iterations to ensure a good fit and then continue fitting until convergence. After the fitting is done, I click OK. Now we have all four data sets here. Let's begin with the data. Let me maximize this data set and here it is. Similarly, this one and this one. Finally, we examine the last one and here it is. Now observe, we have different functions here, Gauss, Gaussian, Gaussian Aim and Gaussian Mod functions. So here is what we have. We have Y naught here, which essentially represents the y-axis offset. It is 5.34198. Here the value is the same, and here it is almost identical. Let me maximize this one a bit more to enhance visibility. So here this one is slightly different from the others. Next, we examine XC, the center of our curve. It is 24.9069, and similarly, the others also show the same value except this one, which is slightly different but close to the others. Now, let's look at the parameter representing the width. It shows a width of around 10 points, but here the width is different. However, if I examine the width here, it is entirely different. Whereas in these two, the width remained the same for Gaussian Mod function and Gaussian Aim. Whereas for Gauss in Gaussian, the width is consistent. Finally, we arrive at the value of greatest interest, which is the adjusted R squared value. The closer it is to 1, the better the fit. Here it is 0.98899, and similarly here it is also 0.98899. So the value of both is the same. In the case of Gaussian imp, it is 0.98899. These three values have the same fitting, whereas this one with a fitting of 0.98874 is slightly less optimal. However, the difference is negligible. This is slightly less than optimal fit, although the difference is of negligible magnitude. We can observe that the fitting in the first three is better than in this one. Thus, we can conduct various types of analysis. For instance, if we want to perform four different analyses on the same dataset, we can plot the data with four layers. Moreover, if we wish to conduct even more comparative analyses using different functions, we can do so simultaneously. This approach allows for the execution of all analyses in this manner. Hence, it provides a swift method to analyze our data, applying various functions or analyses promptly using multiple layers. I hope this video has enhanced your understanding of OriginPro. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more content.